Southern California Prep Insider is brought to you by Toyota Dealers of San Diego.
Now CIF finalist, San Diego Cavers coach. I mean, undefeated still. It seems like no matter what, win, lose, draw, this season's been pretty storybook for you guys.
It's a great time right now, great time for the alumni, great time for all staff and administration, the kids, the community, everybody over there. It's a great time for everybody.
Now take us kind of on campus, into the locker room, just give us the emotions, because oldest football school in San Diego County, San Diego, and also one of the more irrelevant if you look over the last decade, and struggled to win games, struggled to keep head coaches, struggled to keep players from transferring, but all of a sudden, back in a big way. This isn't a 7-3 and we made it to the semifinals. We're building towards something. This is back with an exclamation point. What has this season been like in terms of the transformation on campus?
It's been great. You know, I owe it to this guy right here. He's been the fire. There's been lightness every, you know. And he calls me every week and tells me, I'm going to vote against you. So it was a, no, but, it's been a hard transition. I actually didn't think it was going to go this fast. I got asked early about the same transitions that I had when I was coaching at UC. And we did the exact same thing. The difference is over here than we had over there, the exact same thing. But it just went a little bit faster as far as keeping kids in the community. But because I still have some of my boys at UC I talk to every week, they call me. And, they're still over there playing this senior year. It would have been a great thing. But it's the same thing. So it really wasn't no difference as far as what we did, the methods that we used. Some people look at it like that, but they tend to forget, like, it was the same exact thing we did over there. We had three, returners when I was at UC with Kyle LeBlanc, Quinn Skillen. Those guys are playing at Boise and Idaho State, and that was all I had. So we had to bring up the freshmen early. Same exact thing we had to do at San Diego High. Last year, my quarterback, Meshack, he's 5'2", and, like, with his gear on, he's 78 pounds, Eric Afanos, Raiden Hunter, all those guys were sophomores last year. So we just had a very good junior varsity team, basically. So a lot of people think, like, we got all these transfers. We don't have all these transfers. We have Jaden Wickware and Thomas Marcus. Those are the only two. Everybody else been.
Thomas didn't necessarily sign up to transfer. He just, when your high school closes, you have to go somewhere else.
He has to go somewhere else, And not only do you have to go somewhere else, he lives in North Park. He played for Balboa. Went to Roosevelt Junior High School. He's there, so. He should have been there the whole time.
So at what point during the season did you realize this was happening faster than you thought?
Maybe after the Kearney game. Week 1-5, I thought we had some talent. I thought we were playing at the level that we should have been playing at. Statistically, everybody knows San Diego High should be a Division 5 team. What keeps us up there is the school size, which is kind of unfortunate when you have, less numbers. The history of San Diego High, we've never had 60 players. I only have 17 players, and we bring our freshmen and JV up to make one team. So, I have freshmen on my team right now. Mo, I don't know if you guys seen the playoff. Moses ran for 180 yards. He's a freshman. We also have Chili, who is a starting corner. He's a freshman. So we bring those guys up early just to fill numbers. So we should be a Division 5 team. Won 3 games in the last 10 years. Which is horrible, when you look at it like that. But that was the downfall. We were playing at a higher rate, playing Saints and Cathedrals. It shouldn't have been. So those were some of the things that made us struggle early. And I think the first 5 games was our playing level, playing Southwest and guys like that. Some people, you dummy down. No, they're bigger than us. We're the smallest team every week. So we're actually lower than all these other teams that's been lower, right. Which is unfair. But so that's when I looked at it and said, hey, yeah, we're right where we're at. Once we hit Kearney and they were undefeated too, and I know what type of talent those guys have, that's when I actually said, we might be pretty good. And then it just started rolling from there. But it wasn't until week 6 that I figured out that we might have something here.
You talk about Thomas Marcus. Everyone wants to talk about the type of player that he's been all year and his athleticism and his skill. Can you speak on just the leadership he brings to your team and, corralling this team after, as you said, being historically not the best football team, and now that you guys are together, how he plays a big leadership role on this football team?
Well, Thomas Marcus is definitely a leader. He's been somebody on the team that's actually, he's probably the only one that actually been at this level last year. Even though it was Division Five, he's the only one that actually went to the CIF Championship last year. Even though we get in arguments all the time, he's like, we only beat you guys, we had 17. I'm like, everybody's phenomenal. Everybody on that team is at some powerhouse right now starting. You know, he brought that over to our team where he's like, hey, it's 13 weeks here. And everybody else, you know, when we got to like week 10, it was like kind of drained, like, oh, man. And he's like, no, we got to keep going, got to keep going. He's a real leader on the team. I think he brings the best out of a lot of players. I've seen a lot of players rise to the occasion where they weren't where they were last year because of him. By far, you know, I'm not saying he's the only player, and sometimes people overshadow the whole team because of him. But the reality, Thomas only has 400 yards for us, you know. But when you move him around, he makes everybody else better. You put him at quarterback, you put him at DB, you put him at safety. So he doesn't worry about a lot of stats like that. He worries about everybody doing their job. So I think that's the thing that he does very well on the team.
Oh, but what can we expect this weekend out of this game?
We're going to, you know, I'll tell you this. First of all, you're gonna see a game that's going to end fast, very fast. You know, a lot of people look down at the wing T. You know, you have two teams that keep the ball on the ground. So the clock's going to not stop running. We throw the ball very seldomly. You know, it's not a lot that we throw. You're going to see, smash mouth football. Hamamoto is a coach, and I said this before. I looked up Coach Hamamoto for a long time. He's a great coach. He's one of the coaches right now that I can say, especially with all the coaches in the county, it's not that many that that was done at this high a level, and he's still here. A lot of the guys are done and stuff like that. He's still doing his thing. So you got to prepare for a guy like that. And you can't just say, oh, I'm going to show up and we got Thomas. And no, you got to find out what's going on. So we're going to pair, and it's going to be a smash mouth football. Monta Vista's doing a good job. They've been here before. 2014, they was in CIF in this same division. Then they moved up D3. They went to the playoffs in D3. You know, they know what they're capable of. Our team, this is the first time we ever been here. So we're gonna you know, play smash mouth football. We're both gonna run the ball hard. We're gonna throw the ball here and there and to see who got the better athletes.
So it sounds like it is gonna be a little bit of a track meet, a little bit of a monster truck rally, and all sorts of fun on the finals. Get here early because you're going to miss it if you're more than 10 minutes late. Yeah. The game will already be in the middle of the third quarter. Coach, thank you very much for being on with us, and congratulations on all your success this season.
We got to hear his vote. What's his vote?
Oh, Tommy Moore is making his official prediction early.
This week, I'm going to pick in the Division IV Finals. San Diego. San Diego Capers.
Fire. Love you, man.